Good morning, children. In the previous class, we learnt about what are conductors and what are insulators. Conductors are those materials which allow heat to pass through them. So examples of conductors are iron, aluminium, copper, etc. Insulators are those materials which do not allow heat to pass through them. Examples of insulators are plastic, wood. That's all. Now you have learned how the heat is transferred in solids. In solids, heat is transferred by conduction. So how does heat transfer takes place in water and air? As we know, water and air are bad poor conductors of heat. So let us show by a small experiment how the heat transfer takes place in liquids. Take a round bottom flask or a beaker, pour 2/3 of water in it and place it on a tripod. Arrange the beaker in such a way that it is heated by keeping the candle below that. Now after that, place a crystal of potassium permanganate at the bottom of the beaker and by using a straw. Now heat the water. Now observe what happens. Heat the water by using a candle below the beaker. Observe what happens. Now the water near the flame gets heated and it becomes hot. Now it rises up and the water on the sides and surface of the beaker moves down towards the source of heat, and that air also gets heated up and it becomes hot. Again the cool water again from the sides moves down and it gets heated up. Again this cycle continues till the whole water gets heated up. Now how the heat is transferred here? The mode of transfer of heat in this process is called convection. So what is convection? Convection is a process of the transfer of heat from the hotter end to the colder end with the axial movement of liquids. So this is called convection. Now how the transfer of heat takes place in air? So this is shown by a small experiment. Let us light a candle now. Keep one hand above the flame and the other hand on the side of the flame. Now observe, do you feel both the hands equally hot? Now which hand do you feel more hot? So the air, observe what happens. Now I am feeling hot here, I am not feeling hot here. So how does it happen? Now the air above towards the at the top gets heated due to convection. See, I am feeling hot here, but here towards on the side of the flame I am not feeling hot here. Why? Because the air gets heated due to convection at the top, but the heat is transferred from the flame to this hand by radiation. So here the air doesn't feel much hotter as that at the top. So this is also due to convection process. Let's continue in the next lesson.